I have three things for you today. First, an update on my wife, Cindy. We are in a good place. We have, we are very grateful, very, very grateful for the many expressions of love and support and prayer as well. The progress is steady, it is slow, and we have a few miles to go in the vision and in the cognitive deficits that we need to see progress against. Second, in a part of all of that process, on the 8th of May, I finally received a wake-up call. And this is a personal plea to all of you. On the 8th of May, I received test results from a follow-up to my annual physical. And those results confirmed that I had high triglycerides, high cholesterol. I'm not remembering the third one right now. Oh. Bless you, I just remembered it. I was overweight. I'd been living with those for 4 or 5 years because I could always get to it later. The wake-up call was the fourth one. For the first time in my life, I have high blood pressure. And that day, I decided, enough. Enough. Now, of course, one of the dynamics of what was going on that day was considering what the Lord may have in my future in terms of care for my wife. So I share that with you for this simple reason. If you know you have high triglycerides, if you know you have high cholesterol, if you know that you've been overweight, or if you know that you have high blood pressure, please say, that's enough. Please say, that's enough. Join our wellness plan. Take advantage of the opportunities in the EPC medical plan. Do it for the God you serve, your spouse, your family, your grandkids. Do it for yourself. And I'm not speaking just to boomers here. You young people that we are so hopeful for, if you've got any one of those today, do you honestly think that 10 years from now, life is going to be easier? Doing ministry for Jesus Christ is going to be less challenging? Enough. Enough. My personal plea to you. Thirdly, one of the rich privileges of my position has been the opportunity to serve as a safe place for many, many pastors in the EPC. A distinct aspect of that ministry in 2007 to 2011 was getting that call from a pastor who's leading a church into the EPC. He or she would say, Jeff, please, please pray for me. Pray for our session. We are under spiritual attack. Some spectacular answers to prayer in that. Given the conversations that I've had with pastors in 2019, there is no question in my mind, based on what I hear, that there has been a pause, and that pause has come to an end. The evil one cannot be pleased that Andrew Brunson is no longer in prison. The evil one cannot be pleased that the Lord Jesus has gathered more than 600 churches who are unashamedly committed to the good news that is found only in Jesus Christ. And the evil one cannot be pleased with what our Lord Jesus is doing in the EPC. There is a spiritual connection. There is a cohesion that we have been blessed with that I have been looking for 13 years to see if it's anywhere else in global Presbyterianism. And I have not found it. Now, of course, immediately when the issue of spiritual attack comes up, I go to Ephesians chapter 6, which the summary is also the introduction. Be strong in the Lord and in His mighty power. And when I read that, I am always reminded that I do not have the resources. I do not have the wisdom. I do not have the understanding. I do not have the strength. I do not have the power to engage in spiritual warfare with evil and win. And neither do you. Neither do you. I can't do it. You can't do it. All we can do is seek and trust and rely on the supernatural resources that God, the Holy Spirit, makes available to us in Ephesians 6. I am very grateful and stand amazed still at the incredible mobilization of the EPC in the calls to prayer in the last few years, with Andrew Brunson repeatedly, and for my dear wife Cindy since April. Yet let me share with you this desire of my heart. That is that we would have the same urgency and mobilize for prayer for people with whom we live day in and day out who do not know, do not believe, do not yet trust in Jesus as their personal Savior and Lord, that we would realize that they are going to hell if they do not come to know Him. Second, that we would pray with the same sense of urgency for the lost in our community, that we would pray for the revitalization of our churches, that we would pray for the gospel expansion through church planting and EPC world outreach, and with the same urgency we would mobilize to pray for the next generation of leaders in the EPC. I have not yet figured out how to make that happen. But I'm asking many of you, and more importantly, I am unstoppable in seeking the Lord on this matter. Thank you for the opportunity to serve Christ and you in this ministry as stated clerk. It is not always easy. But it has been rich, rewarding, and humbling. I love you, and I thank you.